through the different slides, no? So the assessment of the head is in it's included in your HEENT, no? Head, eyes, ears, nose, and throat. But for our topic for this morning, we'll just focus on the head, the nose, and the throat because we'll have a separate lectures on eyes and ears. So these are the common concerning symptoms that that the patients complain why they do consult for the HEENT. So headache, sino ba naman ang hindi pa naka-experience ng headache, no? Then changes in vision, blurring of vision, loss of vision, flashing of lights, eye pain, or tearing, redness. Double vision is termed as diplopia, no? And then hearing loss, earache, ringing in the ears is called, ringing in the ears is called tinnitus. Yung when once you hear, and that's ringing of the ears. So dizziness and vertigo, because these are related to your cranial nerve number 8, the cibulocochlear, the vestibule part of the vestibulocochlear nerve, no? So vertigo kung affected din yun. And then there would be nose bleeding, which is termed as epistaxis, sore throat, hoarseness of voice, swollen glands, and the inflammation or the swelling of your thyroid gland, which is the goiter. Now, headache is one of the most common symptoms in clinical practice, classified as primary or secondary primary without identified underlying disease. So common, like migraine, tension, cluster, chronic daily headache. Secondary, there's a reason behind why there is a headache. There's a condition like in subarachnoid hemorrhage, meningitis, inflammation. You always have to think about there is a difference or there is an increase in the intracranial pressure, most probably. So there could be leakage, there could be bleeding, or there is a growing mass impeding on the flow of the circulation. No, so there is buildup of pressure causing the headache. Of course, you always have to ask the 7 attributes of a symptom of headache. That's why we have to ask about the old CAARTS. No, onset, saan yung location, duration, characteristics, and the rest. So the 3 most common important attributes of headache would be severity, the chronologic pattern of the associated symptoms. Ano-ano yung, anong pagkakasunod ng mga symptoms? Anong nauna? Nahilo ba before the headache? Headache muna, wala, hindi kumain before the headache? Ganon. So we have different types of primary types of headache, your tension, migraine, and cluster. Sinus, your paranasal sinuses, when they become infected, they could also cause facial pain or even headache, no? Your migraine and cluster headache occurs more unilateral, no? And then your tension headache bilateral, usually at the temporal areas for the tension. This is a table that could be found in the book that could help you differentiate your primary types of headache, your tension, migraine, and cluster headaches. So you have to ask, is the headache severe or sudden onset? Intensify over several hours, so episodic ba siya or dahan-dahan na di-increase yung pain? No? Is it chronic? Is there a recent change in the pattern, especially for elderly? Does the headache recur at the same time every day? Na-note ba niya every morning when the patient wakes up? What other symptoms, especially weakness or numbness in an arm or leg? So this could be probably due to an associated problem with the nervous system, no? So subarachnoid hemorrhage or meningitis occur severe and sudden. Your subarachnoid hemorrhage is described as the worst headache of my life. Pinakamasakit talaga. So 10 out of 10, pain scale talaga yan siya. As compared to your migraine and tension headaches, episodic, they peak over several hours. And then you have to ask about the patient, especially for elderly patients, no? For new and persisting progressively severe headaches, you have to consider tumor, abscess for infection, and mass lesion. That's the importance of asking also different signs and symptoms, different signs and symptoms associated with a headache. May fever ba? Meron bang pain in the neck? No? And then other symptoms that could be related with the headache. Is there nausea and vomiting? Is there a prodrome of unusual feelings like euphoria, craving for food, fatigue, or dizziness? Is this part of the syndrome? No, napi-feel ba ng patient before the headache? May prodrome ba? May aura ba? Aura could be neurologic symptoms na you could see, or there would be numbness or weakness. These are different signs and symptoms that could be felt by the patient or experienced by the patient before the headache aura. So about a third of patients with migraine experience visual aura. So a study about the photoptias, fortifications, and scotomas. No, scotomas are areas of loss of vision. Merong areas na hindi mo nakikita, blurred. You have to ask or inquire about if the headache is when you cough or sneeze or change the position of the headache of the head. Does it affect the headache? No. Does the headache worsen? No. For example, leaning forward or lying down increase headache. Because if yes, so you could trace or delineate kung ano yung mga conditions that could probably cause the headache. For example, para sinusitis, there is increase in the mucus production in your sinuses that could cause the facial or the headache. Leaning forward, no, when there is increase in the headache while leaning forward, tapos may facial na pressure, then you could say that most probably, and then during physical assessment, pag press yung dito tsaka dito, no, maxillary and frontal sinuses, that you could really say that most probably the patient is having paranasal sinusitis. No, so we'll discuss about different conditions later in a while. So is have to inquire overuse of analgesics, ergotamines, or triptans. You have to think about vasodilators, no, or analgesics. This could lead to parang rebound headache. Okay, let's go to the nose and sinuses. Now, rhinorrhea is refers to the drainage of the nose and is often associated with nasal congestion, no, nasal congestion. So rhinorrhea, again, it's clear, most probably clear discharge from the nose. It is accompanied by sneezing, watery eyes, throat discomfort and itching in the eyes, nose, and throat. So that you can delineate if it is seasonal, is it allergic cause, is it infectious cause. So you ask about the different symptoms. You have to deal with or ask about the history again. No, you have to be able to differentiate the different terms, epistaxis, hemoptysis, and hematemesis. Epistaxis is the bleeding from the nasal passages, no, paranasal sinuses. So you have to trace kung saan ba talaga yung bleeding nag-occurs sa nose ba. Take note that bleeding from the nose could pass to the backside of the pharynx, no, and lalabas sa mouth. So you have to really trace kung saan nanggaling yung bleeding so that you can say if it's really epistaxis. Hemoptysis is coughing up of blood. Pag ubo po niyo, ma'am, may yun po ba ang yun po ba yung time na may dugo, no, coughing up of blood. Or you could say na may ang phlegm, may merong dugo, no, coughing up of blood. So you could say that could be from the respiratory tract. Hematemesis, more of the gastrointestinal tract, vomiting of blood. So to continue for the mouth, throat, and neck, you have to ask about sore throat, pharyngitis, are there sore tongue, ulcers? So parang history pa lang, no, sore tongue, have you observed any ulcers, gum bleeding? So the usual cause of gum bleeding is gingivitis or inflammation of your gums. So have you observed changes in the voice quality or hoarseness? Pagaw ba? Na experience pa ninyo na napagaw mo, ma'am? No? Are there observed swollen lumps or swollen glands? No? Murag naghubag akong diridok, and then you proceed with the physical examination. Of course, as doctors, you have to also be able to know what are the different health teachings that you would give your patients. So, for example, for your mouth, oral health. No, for oral health, clinicians should play an active role in promoting oral health. So, brush your teeth. No, use fluoride-containing toothpaste. Continue brushing and flossing. Annual dental care consult. So, suggested annual. Pero when dentists, no. So, from dentists, it's actually better if you have dental prophylaxis or consult twice a year or every 6 months. Okay, let's proceed. No, avoid excessive intake of foods that are rich in sugars, no, starches, avoid tobacco, and then limit alcohol consumption. And then if you are wearing dentures, remove and clean every night. No, so we have to study about the different regions of the skull because these are related to the The names of the locations are named according to the different portions of the skull, like frontal, parietal, no, temporal, occipital, and such. Okay, so this you have to think about also. So the frontal, parietal, occipital, no, temporal, and this is the mastoid portion of the temporal bone, because when you take note of the different findings during assessment, so saan mo isusulat? Nasa head lang. So there is a lump located at the head. So you have to be specific about that. So saan bang area? 2x2 movable mass, cystic mass, tender to touch, located at the mastoid portion of the temporal bone behind the left ear. Parang ganon. So you have to be more specific about the location. So you have to know about the anatomy. So observe here the different glands. No? So you have your parotid glands, salivary glands. No, observe for the duct here, no, ang duct dito. Take note of the duct. Second molar yan siya lalabas sa upper molar. Second molar at the buccal mucosa. You have here the submandibular glands, no, submandibular just below your nasa mandible below, and then your submandibular duct will open at the sides of your frenulum, lingual frenulum later on. Sige lang, we'll discuss about this later on. And then observe here sa nose natin. It's your nose is composed of bone and cartilage. Okay, bone and cartilage. Study about the different landmarks of the face. You have your glabella here. It's a flat surface in between your eyebrows. This is the medial canthus and lateral canthus of the eye. No, why do you have to know note for the lateral canthus, particularly in some syndromes or some fasces? No, there could be a lowering of the ear. No, when you say low set ears, it's the time wherein the superior portion of your ear is lower than the lateral canthus level. No, lateral canthus level. So this is your nose. You have the root, the dorsum of the nose. You have the your elanasi, no? Then your opening. When you say vestibule, it's the opening, diba? So vestibule of the nose. You have your philtrum, the lips. So study about the different facial landmarks. So I've incorporated here the checklist that you will be performing for your written demonstration or for your video. So you wash your hands, greet the patient, introduce yourself. You always have to explain the procedure. Explaining the procedure and it's not just simply stating that I'm going to do or perform assessment of your head and the neck for this morning. It's not simply like stating so, but you have to also state the importance of doing so. Okay, the importance. Then ask if the patient is ready and secures permission and gets the consent. Now proceeding with the examination of the head, inspect the head, hair, scalp, palpate. Now inspect muna eyes, then palpate the scalp and the skull. And inspect of the face. What are the things that you need to inspect? Note the quantity of the hair, its distribution, may areas but of alopecia. Areas, alopecia means walang buhok, no? Any patterns of loss or baldness, no? So why do you have to do so? Because there are some disease conditions that particularly tell you na probably this could be the disease condition. So for example, just comparing the hair texture of hyperthyroidism and hypothyroidism. No, so sa hyperthyroidism, there is fine hair as compared to hypothyroidism, coarse ang hair ninyo. Then you have to check for infestations. Meron bang kuto? Meron bang different? May nits ba? May lice eggs? No, and then check for dandruff. For the scalp, you need to part the hair. No, part the hair in several places and look for scaliness, lumps, diva, and other lesions. No, so you have to part the hair. So, ipart yun talaga. Pakita yun talaga sa video ninyo that you will really part the hair para makita yun yung scalp. No, so, ganon. So, during the, when you assess for the patient, no, when you assess for the patient in the video, you let the patient, especially for females, kung nakatayo yung hair, alisin yung mga angtay ng hair so that you would be able to assess the scalp properly. Okay? Focus on the picture. Okay, focus on the picture. You could see here na merong lumps, no? Merong probably cystic mass of the head. So if the patient, if the doctor did not part the hair, most probably the patient or the doctor would not be able to identify so or be able to describe the lesions or the masses here more appropriately. No, so you really need to part the hair. For the skull, observe the general size, contour of the skull, note for deformities, depressions, lumps, or tenderness, especially when the patient has already informed you that the patient experienced vehicular accidents before or trauma, fall during childhood, and the like. For the face, note for the patient's facial expression, contour, meron bang asymmetry, no? Dito lang nagmo-move, no? Involuntary movements, edema, and even masses. Of course, for the skin, note for the skin color, pigmentation, texture, thickness of the hair and hair distribution, any lesions. And then, prominent bang acne, no? So, this could be related to different endocrine problems, no? And hirsutism also, especially more prominent in girls. So, hair growth, no? Facial hair growth is prominent during in hirsutism. Just a review, your cranial nerve number 5 is your trigeminal nerve. Your trigeminal nerve has 3 main branches, no, ophthalmic, maxillary, and mandibular division. So your cranial nerve, your cranial nerve 5 or trigeminal nerve is it's a mixed nerve, both sensory and motor. Sensory and motor because of your V3, your mandibular nerve. Now because both of your ophthalmic and maxillary divisions are just sensory nerves. Then cranial nerve number 7 is your facial nerve. No, facial nerve, both sensory and motor pa rin. Sensory part, anterior 2/3 of the tongue, taste, di ba? And then motor would be movement. Kung we let the patient smile, smile equal ba? We let the patient frown, no, close the eyes, try to open to assess for this strength of the different facial muscles like your orbicularis oris, orbicularis oculi, and the like. Balik lang pala ako dito. This is important, no, for the symmetry of the face when you ask the patient to smile, no? This is your nasolabial fold here, no? It's a fold between your nose and your labia, the lips, no? Labia na lips. No, so this is your nasolabial fold. This should be equal. So because when you ask the patient to smile, nanonotice niyo yung nasolabial fold here. Because if there is paralysis of the face, hindi nagmo-move tong dito, so there is flattening of the nasolabial fold. Hindi yan walang nasolabial fold na nakikita. Tong dito lang yung nasolabial fold. Okay? So the nasolabial fold is also an important finding that you need to assess during facial assessment. These are the different branches of the facial nerve, no? Temporal, zygomatic, buccal, mandibular, and your cervical branches. You have to know that my mnemonic for this is two zombies beat my cow. Two zombies beat my cow. Temporal, zygomatic, buccal, mandibular, and your cervical. So inspect for lesions masses. Normal findings, scalp is shiny, no dandruff. Abnormal, there would be bleeding, other lesions, no? And hematomas, bleeding. So inspect the shape of the face, no, normal findings, symmetrical features, your palpebral features, eyes, no, are equal. Shape is oval rather slightly square for the face. For the abnormal findings, there would be deformities, asymmetry as mentioned, no, the right side or one side is different from the left. And then is there acromegaly or hydrocephalus? Acromegaly is are the different features presented in the picture here, no, because of the increase in the growth hormone, no, for the adults. And then like Bell's palsy, which is a temporary disorder affecting the cranial nerve number 7, so producing a unilateral facial paralysis. So these are the different different findings that you could observe in a patient with Bell's palsy. So observe saan ang paralysis niya, nasa right or nasa left? It's on the right side, no? Because see here, there's a sagging of the face on the right side and your nasolabial fold would not be really appreciated. And then flattened yung affect niyo on the right side, no? Inability to close the eyes, resulting in irritation, no? So kaya we blink so that we could maintain the moisture of the eyes. Okay, let's proceed to the mandible. Palpate your TMJ. Okay, try palpating your TMJ or your temporomandibular joint. It's in front of your tragus. I hope you could still remember your anatomy, your tragus of the ear. In front of the tragus would be where your TMJ is. And then you open and close your mouth. Mapifeel yun yan ang joint. Yung joint na ito, no, sa mandible and your temporal area. No, so, normal finding, smooth lang dapat siya, and then no clicking or crepitus, no, no pain. Let's go to facies. Facies, when you say facies, these are like patterns. Patterns of the facial features. Patterns of the facial features that you could observe. For example, there's a particular condition na ganito talaga ang mga mukha nila. You could observe that these are the different findings of the face. Now, so let's discuss some of them. Like in Cushing syndrome, wherein there is increase in the cortisol hormone. So probably there could be increase also of the ACTH, adrenocorticotropic hormone, which increases or stimulates your adrenal gland to produce your cortisol. No, so there could probably be also a pituitary tumor for that matter. Now, so in Cushing syndrome, you could observe facies including moon-shaped face, parang may edema of the face, no, erythematous skin, observe sa pictures, nagpula na yung face niya. Hirsutism may also be present, especially if the condition is caused by adrenal cancer or there is a mass sa adrenal gland natin, which causes it to also increase the production of the cortisol. Nephrotic syndrome, so glomerular diseases, causes excess albumin excretion. As you know, albumin plays a part in the osmotic pressure. So there will be decrease in the intravascular colloid osmotic pressure causing hypovolemia. So there will be sodium water retention for that matter for decompensation. No, so the face becomes edematous, often pale, so there is swelling, and then if it's really severe, slit-like na yung eyes because of the swelling. Okay. So, mixed edema is a condition wherein there is severe hypothyroidism, decrease in our thyroid hormones. So, mucopolysaccharide deposition in the dermis could happen. So, there will be dull and puffy facies also. So, there could also be periorbital edema. Hair and eyebrows are dry, coarse, and thin because nga decrease nga yung thyroid hormones natin. So, metabolism is also slow. Ang proteins na needed for the hair is also decreased. So, there is also dry skin. Parotid gland enlargement. Your parotid glands are located here, no, just in front of your ear at the top of the angle of the mandible, no. So dito. So, swelling either one side or the two parotid glands. So, swellings anterior to the ear lobes, no, and then gradual unilateral enlargement suggests neoplasm, unilateral. And then occlude enlargement is seen in mumps, which is caused by a virus. Acromegaly, as mentioned, is due to an increase in growth hormone. No, so there is enlargement of the bones and then soft tissues, including your nose, lips, and ears. Hyperthyroidplasia. So usually, ganito yung mga mukha ng mga students when the patient, when the doctor announces for a surprise squeeze. No, hyperthyroid facies, parang may hyperthyroid facies ang lahat. So note for fine moist skin with fine hair, there is exophthalmos, bulging of the eyes, no, due to the increase also of the thyroid hormone pushing the eyes outwards. No? So hyperthyroid facies pa rin to. Started expression, nagugulat. Down syndrome, no, so not depressed nasal bridge. Lahat na, almost all, na, ay yung, kung may Down syndrome talaga yung patient, same talaga yung mga characteristics of face nila. Di ba? Napansin niyo. Low set ears. No? So, the superior portion of the ear is lower, or somehow lower than the level of the lateral canthus. Large tongue. No? So, let's proceed with the nose. So, you proceed with the inspection of the external nose. Your external nose is composed or supported by the upper third by a bone, remember, by a bone, and then the later the lower two thirds by cartilage, na kaya yun na move yung nose ninyo. So performance of the sniff test, actually sniff test is also could be done in the assessment of the cranial nerve number 1, which is the olfactory nerve. So you have to, excuse me, you have to ask the patient to close his eyes and then occlude one of the nostrils, and then yung stimulus ninyo or yung object na ipapaamoy ninyo should not be identifiable when you see it, no? When you see it. So it should be inside a bottle that is not transparent, no? So close eyes and then pass smell. Sniff, inhale. And then ask the patient kung ano yung amoy, ano yung object na yun, or ano yung naamoy na, kung ano yung naamoy niya. And then use only mild scents, okay? Mild scents. You could use coffee, soap, mild soap, no? And then you also do it on the other side. So inspection of the internal nasal cavity, the nasal cavity. We use this, particularly in your book, no? We use the otoscope, no? Otoscope for the checking of the nasal cavity. You palpate for the paranasal sinuses, and then you are assessed on how you handle the technique or how you handle the lighting apparatus, your otoscope, no? So let's discuss the anatomy muna of the nose, medial and lateral walls. This is for the medial wall, so it's composed of the nasal septum. Same with the external nose, upper third is composed of bone. Upper third is composed of bone, and then the lower third, particularly made up of cartilages formed by the nasal septum, covered with mucous membrane, supplied with blood. And the vestibule, the opening, no, is composed of hair-bearing skin. Vestibule opening. So covered with mucous membrane, which is supplied with blood. Kaya pag-insert natin yung speculum ng otoscope, no, ng otoscope, try na hindi siya sa septum nyo hindi nyo ma-hit yung septum, no? More on sa cartilage kayo na pag-insert na sa nose. Okay? So you have here your frontal sinus, sphenoid sinus. We'll discuss about those different sinuses later. Okay, this is the lateral wall of the nose. It's composed of the turbinates, which are curving bony structures. This one. Now, so you have your superior, middle, and inferior turbinate. Now, turbinate. So the structure below your turbinate, which is a groove, no, you call that your meatus, or you have your three meati named according to the turbinate that they are below of. No? So this is your superior meatus, inferior meatus, and then this is your inferior meatus. Okay? So your nasal lacrimal duct drains to your inferior meatus. No? So your duct. So ano nga yung nasal lacrimal duct? So there's a duct connecting your eyes and your nose, no? Nasolacrimal duct. So notice that when you cry, when was the last time you cried? No? Sana hindi last night. Nasolacrimal duct. If you have observed when you cry, no, your cry, when you cry, your nose also cries. Now because there's a connection between your eyes and your nose, no? So there's draining of your tears towards your nose, particularly at the inferior meatus. And most of your paranasal sinuses, they all drain to your middle turbinate, middle meatus. Most of your paranasal sinuses, if you have observed, if you have paranasal sinusitis, no, so infection of your sinuses, may colds din kayo usually because nga nagdi-drain din ng your paranasal sinuses also drain to your middle meatus. Okay, check for the tenderness of the nasal tip, no, is there presence of furuncle? No, observe for the color also, redness, which is a sign of infection, meron pus and the like. So these are your paranasal sinuses. Our paranasal sinuses are air-filled cavities within the bones of the skull. The one of the functions of your cavity, nasal cavity, so air-filled dapat sila. It makes the head light, no, it makes the head light. However, when the mucous membrane is infected, they produce more mucus, and then instead of air-filled paranasal sinuses, they are filled with mucus na. That's the reason why when you have paranasal sinusitis, no, inflammation of the lining of your paranasal sinuses, kaya one of the symptoms is head heaviness because of nga, instead of air, meron ng fluid inside. No, so you have here your frontal, your ethmoid, and your inferior meatus. Your sphenoid, yung dito, no, is embedded more inside, so not readily palpable. However, your frontal here, your frontal and your maxillary sinuses are the sinuses that are readily accessible for palpation. This is how you palpate for your frontal and maxillary sinuses. No, kung tender to touch, and then sa history na nagsisneeze, merong nasal sinuses, nasal discharge, and then may head heaviness and the like. So most probably we lean more on the diagnosis that the patient probably could have paranasal sinusitis. As mentioned, sinusitis, there is inflammation of the lining, mucous membrane, there is increase in the mucus production instead of air na. So this is an otoscope, no? This is a device used. This is the speculum here. We insert the speculum, no? Tapos merong area here that you could see what's inside. So may magnifying area here that you could see ano yung nasa loob. No, so you inspect the nares with an otoscope, and you use the largest available ear speculum, no? Para makita ninyo what is readily seen with an otoscope. Or even with the nasal speculum, I'll discuss that after this. Ang nakikita lang readily are your middle and inferior turbinates, ninyo, no? Middle and inferior turbinates. The middle is not always seen. Middle turbinate is not always seen unless specifically if you use the congestants to assess really the middle turbinate. Superior, not really readily seen because more located superior and posterior yung superior turbinate natin. These are your middle and inferior turbinates. This is a nasal speculum, no? Nasal speculum. So kung when you squeeze these parts here, na open tong dito. And we could also use the head mirror, no? Head mirror. Head mirror siya because we use this device to reflect the light, no? So kung I'm using a head mirror, my light, so reflect ang light papunta dun sa area ng nose or sa mouth kung when the area where we want to assess. No, so this is how you use the nasal speculum. Actually, the ENTs or our otorhinolaryngologists, ENT doctors, more prefer the speculum. But however, in your return demonstration, otoscope ang gagamitin natin. But I just want to inform you that you could use the nasal speculum. So you open it this way, and then you would be able to appreciate these different structures. No, so this is your nasal septum. No, nasal septum bulging na dito. This is your middle turbinate. Middle meatus here. This is your inferior turbinate. This is the floor of your nasal cavity. Okay, so we have here nasal polyps. This is a common finding, one of the more common findings or abnormal findings that you could look for, especially when the patient complains of nasal congestion, chronic nasal congestion. No, nasal polyps are pale sac-like growths of inflamed tissue that can obstruct the air passage or sinuses. So how are you going to differentiate it if it's a polyp or a turbinate? No, turbinate are richly vascularized, so it makes the turbinate pink. No, as compared to nasal polyp, ang nasal polyp, avascular siya, wala siyang vessels, and therefore, it's pale. One of the differences also is your turbinate has innervation, while your nasal polyp has none, so kung i-maneuver ninyo ang nasal polyp, wala siyang pain. No, there's no pain. And then, with the location, turbinates are located laterally. However, for nasal polyps, it could happen or it could grow anywhere. No? So these are some of the differences between turbinates and polyps. Epistaxis, again, is the bleeding of the nasal passages. So you have to trace kung saan yung bleeding. No? So, particularly at the septal area, kaya din, aside from sensitive ang septum natin, no, because it's richly innervated, no, there is also what we call Caecebach plexus. I hope you can remember your anatomy. This is the anastomosis of the different small vessels of the nose, no, particularly your anterior ethmoidal, posterior ethmoidal arteries, phenopalatine artery, your greater palatine artery, and the septal branch of your superior labial artery, so Caecebach plexus. So the usual cause of epistaxis or nose bleeding is when you pick your nose, no, yung nangungulangot paminsan kung sobra, dumudugo na yung nose, especially for school age children, no, and then it's delicate, it's friable ang arteries natin dyan. That's why most common cause ng epistaxis is nasal picking. Okay, epistaxis. So let's proceed to the mouth. Examination of the mouth inspects the lips, the perioral area, your oral cavity. So when we say mouth, it's only the vestibule, it's only the opening. No, but the proper term when we assess for the structures inside our mouth, no, is oral cavity. Don't forget about that. Okay, oral cavity. So inspect the gums, the teeth, the palate, soft and hard palate, your oropharynx, posterior. You need to include the A test, no? The A test. Now, it's a test wherein we request the doc, the patient to say okay? And then we assess natin later on yung rise ng soft palate. We'll discuss this in a while. Okay? Inspection of the tongue, no? The floor of the mouth. So we ask the patient to lift the tongue up. Then you are also graded according to your technique or how you handle the lighting apparatus, your pen light, and then how you handle your tongue depressor or your tongue blade, no? So paano niyo maneuver, no? So I suggest you wear your gloves here because if you don't have it's not really clear kung ano yung structures inside, you could use your fingers or your hands to open, no? As long as you use your gloves, okay? So you observe for the lips, the color, moisture, oral mucosa, is it moist? Are there ulcers? For gums and teeth, are there bleeding? Incomplete ba yung teeth? Discolored ba yung teeth? And the like, no? So observe for the teeth, no? Gingival margin, interdental papillae over here. Kung may swelling ba, may bleeding ba dito sa sides na ito. Your teeth, are the teeth complete? No, we have, in an adult, there are 32 teeth. No, so 16 up, 16 down. And then for conventional identification, the teeth are numbered. Okay, 1 to 16 from right to left, upper, 1 to 16, lower, 17 left to right, 17 to 32 left to right. No, so 1 to 16 upper to left, right to left, 1 to 16 upper, lower, 17 to 32 left to right. Okay. So normally, gums pinkish siya. So pwede ding medyo dark na for especially for darker individuals. You have here your slit-like portion, labial frenulum. Be sure when you use your tongue depressor, hindi nyo nahihit yung frenulum na yan. This connects your inner portion of your labial mucosa to your alveolar mucosa, no? Near the gingiva, the gums. No? So study about the composition of the teeth. You have your enamel, which hard portion. You have your dentine. Then you have your vessels, no, your artery, then meron ding nerve. That's why kung merong cavities na sumisira sa teeth natin, so it causes tooth pain, no? Especially when it triggers already a stimulus to your nerve. Okay? Study about the different Different types of teeth, no? Your molar, premolar, your canine, your incisors. Okay? Canine, mga bangkil, no? Fangs. Okay, your papillae, it's rough. Your tongue is composed of different papillae. That's why your tongue is rough. No? So you ask the patient to lift the tongue up, observe for the lingual frenulum. No, that, so the opening of your submandibular glands, no? So submandibular glands are located here. Okay, submandibular glands here. So when you let the patient raise the tongue up, no? So nakita ninyo itong lingual frenulum, no? Lingual frenulum, at the side of it, you could see there the openings of the duct of your submandibular gland ducts, okay? So here for the posterior pharynx, no? Your oropharynx, ang delineation niya from the oral cavity, oropharynx, happens after the posterior part of your soft palate, no? Posterior part of your soft palate. Okay. So you have here your posterior and anterior pillars. No, posterior and anterior pillars. You could see here at the right tonsil, no, medyo reddish siya and bulging. As compared to the left, wala. This is the normal. The normal ang nasa left. No, walang bulging of the tonsil. So this could be a starting tonsillitis na. Dito mas malala na, no? So both of the tonsils, tapos meron ng purulent dito na component, no? Exudates. So this is your uvula. Okay, this is your uvula, parang tongue-like projection, no, of your soft palate uvula. It should be at the center. Okay? This is your buccal mucosa. Your buccal mucosa is the interior part of your cheeks, no? Particularly at the second upper molar, you see the opening of your parotid ducts. Okay, left and right. Second molar, upper. Opening of your parotid. Your parotid ducts is also named as your Stenson's duct. Okay, Stenson's. And then while your submandibular ducts, Wharton's. Or the interchange ko ba? Yun yata, Stenson's and Wharton's duct. Okay, you have your check for presence of ulcers. As mentioned, kung hindi makita yung sa sides ng tongue, you ask the patient to move the tongue. No, check natin kung ano yung you have to observe also the sides of the tongue. Kung hindi masyadong makita or hindi alam ng patient to move, you could assist by donning your gloves and then maneuvering the tongue. Okay? Or the different parts of your mouth. Okay, this is particularly, there is inflammation of your gingiva, no, walang ibing, because the patient wears dentures, no, nag-infect na, and then there is stomatitis here. So different, no, when there were whitish portions, we call it exudates in our tonsils. This is evident in, this is true for more serious tonsillitis, no? So our uvula should be at the center, no? There is inflammation and may exudates na. Ayun. Cross the tongue, inspect the lateral margins also. So differentiating here the tongue and the uvula. So tongue, we ask the patient to stick the tongue out. This is innervated by our hypoglossal nerve, no? Cranial nerve number 12. Motor nerve siya. So, it should be at the center. The tongue muscles are, ang orientation niya, mag-point siya towards the midline. No? Ang strength niya pointing to the midline. So, when we stick the tongue out, no, if this is my tongue, papunta siya sa center. So, center dapat. But if there is a lesion on the right side or paralysis on the right side, so weak na yung right. So, the tongue pushes it to the right side. So the tongue, the abnormality, the tongue points to the side of the lesion, kung saan yung abnormal. No? Mnemonic for this, from med school, the tongue licks the wound. No? Have you observed na kung meron kayong sugat sa mouth, parang tongue niya can't help but parang nililick niya. Yeah? So the tongue licks the wound. As yung sa ah test, let the patient say ah, di ba? When we let the patient say ah, the soft palate rises. Stop. Okay? The uvula, no? The uvula, this one is your uvula, should be at the center. No? This is innervated by your cranial nerve number 10, your vagus nerve. No? If there is a problem with the right side, so hindi siya mag-elevate. So the left side, which is the normal, will rise, no? So your uvula points to the normal side, no? Kasi hindi nga nagre-raise to. Okay, so ayun. Comparing the two, the tongue points to the where the lesion is or the abnormal side, and while your uvula points to the normal side. Okay? So tongue points towards the left side dito. So the lesion is at the left side. So let's proceed to the neck. You inspect, palpate the neck. So normal findings, there should be full range of motion. The full range of motion of the neck, there is a flexion, extension, lateral flexion, not then turning to the sides then. No. Full range of motion. Then you have to study about the anatomy. So yun nga, you have to study about the anterior and posterior triangles of the neck. No, so the borders of the anterior and posterior, of course, bordered by your sternocleidomastoid. Your sternocleidomastoid has two heads. There's connection between your manubrium, your sternum, and then your clavicle, and then also connected to your mastoid process of your temporal bone. No, and then study about the borders of your anterior and posterior triangles. What are the different subtriangles? No, so midline of the neck, anterior of the of these sternocleidomastoid, your mandible, posteriorly, posterior triangle, clavicle, posterior portion of your sternocleidomastoid, and your anterior portion of your trabeceus. So study about the different triangles. Okay? So occipital and supraclavicular triangles, posterior, anterior. You have your submental, submandibular. You have your carotid and your muscular triangles. Okay? The anatomy of the different vessels, the external and internal jugular vein, your carotid artery. And then some midline structures of the neck. Of course, you have to study about the hyoid bone. Peculiar about the hyoid bone, it's a bone that has no direct articulation with other bones. No? And it's movable. And then you have your thyroid cartilage. No? So especially for men, it's prominent. It makes up your Adam's apple or your laryngeal prominence. Ito. So when you palpate below your thyroid cartilage, now you have your cricoid cartilage na dyan, and in between, dyan tayo gumagawa ng cricoid thyroidectomy. Cricothyroidotomy. We incise the cricothyroid membrane to have access for emergency access for airway when there is an upper obstruction. Diba? And then you have your windpipe or your trachea, and then this is your thyroid gland. There are two lobes and then connected to one another by an isthmus. No? So your thyroid gland is particularly found near your cricoid, below your cricoid cartilage, and then cricoid cartilage, and it's in between the your sternocleidomastoid, no? Median. Below. No, because this is the common reason during palpation by the students, and when the students palpate for the thyroid gland, dito na sila, nasa thyroid gland na sila, ay thyroid cartilage sila banda. So look for the cricoid, below the cricoid nandiyan yung thyroid gland natin, and it's in between the sternocleidomastoid. Okay? Okay, lateral view, study thyroid gland, inflammation, goiter, here, enlargement of the thyroid. So this could probably lead to hyperthyroidism. Okay, study about the different signs and symptoms, differentiating hyperthyroidism from hypothyroidism. More, ikaw ba ang unang nagre-reklamo na malamig ang area, ang room, or mainit parate? So, hyperthyroidism, heat intolerance, cold intolerance for hypothyroidism. Yung nga, so for the head and neck, sa hair, fine hair, compared to coarse hair. Okay? As about hoarseness of voice, problem chronic, lasting for more than 2 weeks, tobacco use, is there hemoptysis, coughing up of blood, weight loss, unilateral throat pain? And for the lymph nodes, you have to assess for the lymph nodes. Normally, the different lymph nodes are not palpable, kaya hindi natin siya masyado na-appreciate. However, once there is an infection or adenopathy, there is an ongoing infection, no, so the lymph nodes are enlarged and they become tender when palpated and they are palpable na. So these are the different lymphatic drainages. This is important because when we try to assess kung saan ang galing yung infection or saan yung infection, no, so we look for the lymphatic drainages. No, so these are the different nodes, lymph nodes that you're going to palpate. Preauricular. How are you going to palpate? Dapat circular motion, parang ganito. Don't worry, I'm going to post videos. Or you could look in YouTube. No? Palpate, preauricular, postauricular behind the ear, no, at your occipital or mastoid area. And then occipital, dito pala, occipital at your occipital bone. Hindi lang isahang ganun, ha? Because hahanapin mo kung meron bang lymph nodes. Ganun. Tonsillar, near the blade, no? Near the angle of your mandible, tonsillar. Submandibular, submental, cervical lymph nodes. Your cervical lymph nodes, merong superficial, merong deep, merong posterior cervical lymph nodes. Your superficial and deep lymph nodes are termed superficial and deep, relating it to their position with the sternocleidomastoid muscle. Now, superficial, it's superficial above your sternocleidomastoid. It's deep because it's deep to your SCM, sternocleidomastoid. So posterior, nasa likod or in front of your trapezius. Now, so for superficial, ganon. For deep, try nyo ganunin, gawing ganito. Yung try to palpate for the deep cervical lymph nodes. So it's deep to your sternocleidomastoid. Now, try nyo palpate the left and the right. Okay? Posterior cervical and then supraclavicular above your clavicles. No? Okay. Sige. So the different lymph nodes, study about lymph adenopathies, no? Ayun. So palpating the preauricular, postauricular, submandibular, supraclavicular lymph nodes. So yun nga, inspect the neck, palpate the head and the neck and lymph nodes, then the different lymph nodes. You need to also palpate the trachea. Is the trachea at the midline? Midline ba siya? Kasi kung hindi midline, meron napupush siya towards the sides. So there could be a problem. Probably, there could be a mass growing on one side, pushing the trachea towards the other side. Or when there's a problem already with the lungs, no? Merong pushing of the trachea to one side. No? So inspect also the thyroid gland while swallowing and palpate the thyroid organ. So palpate the trachea if it's at the midline. No, thyroid gland during at rest and when the patient swallows. So you could observe here during at rest, normal ang thyroid gland. But as compared to someone who has swelling of the thyroid gland or enlargement of the thyroid gland in goiter. No? So cricoid cartilage, thyroid gland below the cricoid cartilage. Why do I need to let the patient swallow when we palpate for the thyroid gland? Because this will differentiate it. This will tell you that the mass, for example, or the enlargement is from the thyroid gland because during swallowing, the thyroid gland will move with swallowing. Okay? The thyroid gland will move with swallowing. If it is stationary, meaning it will not move with swallowing, probably the mass or the enlargement is not from the thyroid gland, but it is from other structures of the neck. Like, pwedeng muscular, pwedeng nasa skin lang yung mass, no? Pwedeng nasa trachea and the like, no? So, this differentiate it when you palpate, no? Ideally, is the doctor or the examiner would go behind the patient. So, kamay na to ng examiner, palpate niya yung thyroid gland, and then you ask the patient to swallow. So, the thyroid gland will move with swallowing, no? Up and down. Okay. Then, to close, you summarize the findings, normal interpret the findings, provides education to the patient, kaya kailangan kung you have to be knowledgeable about what are the teachings that you need to do for the patient and ask the patient for further clarifications and questions, and then you thank the patient.